Hello and welcome. Today I'm going to be demonstrating how to set up a virus prank that you can use on your friends, family, and really whoever else you choose to use it on. Just real quick, little disclaimer, have to get this out of the way. I am not held responsible or accountable for any issues that can and may occur to your PC or device that you're trying to do this on. This video is meant for educational purposes only. Now that that's out of the way, this specific prank that we're going to do will actually not negatively impact the computer. It may slow it down, but chances of it crashing your hard drive are very minimal. So real quick, just to kind of cover what I've seen a lot on YouTube, I've seen some pranks out there where they open up the command prompt, do a bunch of crazy things, and that's really it. Cool. There's other ones where you can have dialog boxes open up, and it's just, you know, just one prompt after another, and it just keeps going and going and going until it completes the cycle. Awesome. Now, I haven't really seen any videos out there that combine all these together, and that's what I'm actually looking to achieve in this one. So real quick, I'm actually going to show you how to get this set up correctly and how it's going to look as a final result. So what's really going to make this unique, like I said, we're going to be combining a lot of things that you see on YouTube into one quote-unquote virus. But what's really going to give that person the oh crap factor is we're actually going to be throwing in a shutdown command as well. So what that's going to do is for this video, we're going to have this set up on a 35-second delay. So once we actually launch the program, 35 seconds from launching it, the computer will shut down on you, or me. Now just for this video, I'm actually not going to have it shut down. I'm going to cancel it out for obvious reasons. I don't want to lose you guys here. So to make this work correctly, there's two file types we're going to use. There's a VBS file and a BAT file. Now, BAT is one of the most common ones you see out there. VBS, not so much. It's not really a cool thing. It's more of a nuisance, really. So in the comments, or excuse me, in the description below, the BAT file will be there 100% for you to copy and paste just to save you some time. However, the VBS file, I'm not going to post it there. I will be giving you the tools to create your own. Don't worry, it doesn't matter how advanced of a user you are or if you're a complete noob. I mean, I'm not a professional myself, as you can tell. But the tools will be there, and they are actually very simple to use. So real quick, just to show you what a VBS file is going to look like as the end result, this is what it looks like, or what mine looks like. So like I said, VBS is just a dialog box. It's annoying. It's like a pop-up on your computer. All it says, virus has been detected, or whatever you want to put there. Do you want to perform scan, internal error, deleting files, blah, 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 blah. Now this last section, you're kind of looking at it as like, what the hell? All I simply did was create the one command line and copied it a bunch of times. Now the reason for that, like I said, we're putting this on a timed shutdown. So what I'm really trying to do here is buy some time. It's only 35 seconds. Now yes, I could reduce the time. However, I'm really kind of negating the whole, are they going to see the dialog box, or are they actually going to go through everything? I want to give them enough time to see that the last command line here, because that's really going to put a sweat on them. So again, I'm just going to give you the tools to create your own, kind of give you more of a fun factor, really, rather than have you just sit there, copy and paste, and woo, it's done. Alright, so the BAT file, edit. This is what it looks like. Much, much simpler than the VBS file. Really nothing to it, but it actually does a lot. So at echo, you absolutely need that in order for the file to launch correctly. Excuse me, I know I'm tripping over my words tonight. Now the first one, you don't have to have this. I just simply put it in there. All it does is it changes the color. Now your background, as you can see, this is white. On the command prompt, it keeps the black background, but I have it set to change the text color, so the text will actually be green. Now the next line I have on here, this is where you can really kind of set this up the way you want to, or how you know this person works. Mine is set to start Google Chrome. Now if you notice on my desktop here, this is my final result here. I do use Google Chrome a lot on this computer, and so do other people in my household. So that is a big reason why I chose to use this. Now you can have this set to a bunch of other things, like if you're using Internet Explorer, I don't know why you would, because it's a piece of crap, but you'd be using iExplorer.exe or whatever it is you want to use. Now, if you're confused on which one to put in here, if you're not sure what the executable file is or what it actually shows up as, there's a very easy way to find out. Simply launch whatever it is you want to use, open up your task manager, and what you want to do is look under processes. So in processes, you'll see on the very, very far left here, it says chrome.exe or fraps.exe or whatever. Now if it has like an asterisk 32 or anything like that, you don't have to put that there. It's not needed. It's not going to impact anything. Just make sure that this matches. So chrome.exe. Yes, it matches. Cool. It will work. Now the next line here, this is for the command prompt. Timeout, time is 5 seconds. Now, you don't really have to put the timeout here. I'm only doing that just really for the video purpose of demonstrating this to you. Excuse me. All this is really going to do is it's going to ensure that Google Chrome is the first thing that loads along with the command prompt. And after this time's down, the next thing that will pop up on my screen will actually be the VBS file or the dialog box. So even if they don't see the command prompt come up, they will see the dialog box come up because it will show up on top of Chrome. And hopefully that'll be enough to redirect them back to their desktop. Now, here's your shutdown command. Very, very simple, shutdown.exe. The next parts to it, the first part is actually telling you what type of shutdown to use. There's a few of them. S is a full-blown shutdown, R is to restart the computer, and H is to hibernate the computer. So for this video, I have it set to shutdown. Now, the next part is a timer, that'd be /T. Like I said, we're putting this on a 30-second. For some of you out there going, well, wait, you said 35 seconds. Yes, I did. We have a 30-second delay on the shutdown plus the 5-second delay on the command prompt. So 30 plus 5 is 35 seconds. Again, you can kind of set this up however you want. Like I said, you don't have to have the timeout. You can set this to 10 seconds, 1 second, whatever. Does not matter. The next part here is you're basically assigning a section or a chapter or whatever you want to call it. Like I said, I'm not an expert here. I don't know the technical term. We're naming this section S. And you can pick that as A, B, C, whatever you want, just as long as the final line on this, the go-to, matches. And basically what this is, it's a loopback. So it continuously does this over and over and over and over. Now in the middle here is what it's doing. It's basically just scanning the computer, the directory, or whatever you want to call it. So all it does is it's looking up a bunch of different files on your computer, and it's just cycling through, cycling through, cycling through. Just to kind of show you what that's going to look like, let me go ahead and save this real quick. We'll minimize that, and we will launch this. So, as you can see, really nothing to it. It's just on a continuous loop, and if you hold down the little scroll bar there, you can actually kind of see what it's going through. BioWare, Mass Effect 3, BioWare, Mass Effect 3. Okay, you really like Mass Effect 3. Oh, there's Mass Effect 1. Battlefield, yeah. Cool, you're just scanning my games. So let's just close that out because, yeah, we don't really need to see the rest of it. There was only one instance where I guess it pushed my processor to 100%. I don't know how that happened. So I'm running quad-core i7 Extreme Series, and yeah, that shouldn't have happened. But anyway, it's actually a very minimum load on the computer, but if you keep letting it run, I don't know why, but it just seems to put a load on the processing power. And it actually, even after I told the shutdown to abort, it did shut down my computer anyway. So, don't know what exactly happened there. But, again, like I said, issues may occur on your PC. I'm not held responsible. Alright, we'll save that as the file it's supposed to be. And we're going to close that out. So, to get both these files up and working, just like you normally would, you're actually going to set them both up in Notepad. Excuse me. Now, the VBS, like I said, I'm really going to kind of let you do your own thing with that. Again, I'm going to give you the tools, don't worry. The most important thing you need to know in order to get that working, VBS, is once you're done setting it up how you want to, go to File and Save As. Now, you want to make sure you save this as the correct file or this will not function correctly. Now, you can name this whatever you want, prank.vbs. Very, very important you put that there. Now, I'm actually not going to save that because I have it right here on my desktop. Same thing goes for the batch file or the BAT. Whenever you're done with the... Yeah, we got it all set up. Yeah, it looks good. Save as. Prank, virus, whatever you want it to be again. And make sure you put that .bat at the end. Very, very important. Now, obviously, if you're trying to prank somebody else, you don't want to save them to the desktop here. You're probably going to want to put them somewhere else where they're not really going to look for it. So for this, mine are actually in my documents here. The reason why that's important is because when you're setting up the batch file, notice the VBS file, you have to know the path to get there. So for me, you're telling it to start, look in the drives, your C drive, and then follow the correct path. After you get the correct path in there, give it a space, and then put whatever you saved it as. So for me, it was prank.vbs. Now, if you're unsure of how to find it, let's see, just something simple. In a documents, or maybe you do know what the file path is, but you're unsure how to put it in there. If you just simply right-click whatever you want and go into properties, under properties in the general tab, it'll actually have the location here for you. So you can actually just simply highlight that, copy and paste it, and then put it into your batch file. Very, very simple. Okay, now once that's all done, you definitely would just want to double check, make sure everything's correct, and if you simply want to test it, go ahead and launch it to make sure everything works correctly. Now, I didn't really show how the VBS file works, so real quick, I'm just going to show that. So when you open it, again, it's just a dialog box. So the way this works, it's just like pop-ups. When you hit OK, doesn't care. It's just going to keep cycling through. Doesn't matter if you hit cancel or the X, it's just going to keep doing it until it is done. So if you're testing this to make sure it works, obviously the last one here, you may just want to put it once rather than a million times like I did. But if on the off chance you did put it a lot of times where it's just really, really annoying, hold down the Enter key on your keyboard there and it'll actually cycle it through and make it go through a lot faster. So give me one second, I'm going to do that here. And we're done. That took like 3 seconds. Alright, so now that the VBS is working correctly, the batch file is working correctly, the last thing you want to do, wherever your batch file is, for me it's in the documents, I don't know where you put it, but you want to find it. Reason being is we want to keep it hidden, so what you can do is simply right click on it, you're going to want to send to your desktop. The reason you want to do this is because you want to create it as a shortcut. If you're trying to change the icon on the actual file itself, you're going to find you can't do it. You can only do it on the shortcuts. So I have my shortcut right here, the Google Chrome. Now, if you want to change the icon to something else, because obviously I'm using Chrome, you're probably not going to. Like, let's say you want to change it to the antivirus. Well, you need to know where the file path is for that icon. So an easy way to do that is if I just simply left-click on the icon itself, because this is a shortcut, and then right-click and go into properties like it normally would. Again, you're going to see your computer might be different than mine, but you will see an icon that says change icon. So what you do here is simply click on that, and here's your address or your path to get to this icon. Now, just simply copy that real quick, Control-C, and we're actually going to cancel out of this. So if I want to change this to the antivirus, I'm going to go into the properties again, go into change icon, and what you actually want to do here is go into browse. So in browse, it's going to ask you, well, do you know the file name? Yes, we do. We're going to paste that file name or that path or whatever we found and hit open. And bam, there you go. There's the icon that I wanted for the antivirus. That'll work for just about any shortcut that you create on your desktop. There are some that it will not work for. And if you wanted to get it to work, you have to go online and Google it you have to download the correct image or whatever is required to get that icon. But for this video, we're just simply going to use the Chrome icon. Now again, normally I would change this to Google Chrome, but we're not going to do it right now. So finally, we're down to the end result. What is this going to look like? Now, like I said, this will shut down my computer in about 35 seconds. So I'm actually going to cancel that feature out just so I don't lose you guys here. But okay, let's go ahead and launch this and see what happens. Oh crap, Google Chrome. It did load, don't worry. It's just I had it minimized. Okay. You will be shut down in less than a minute. Crap. Well, let me go in to the command prompt here and cancel that out before I lose you. Shut down, abort. Shutdown has been canceled at the bottom right there. Alright. So, for you and me, we know how to cancel out the shutdown so we don't lose anything. We already know this is just a bunch of gibberish. It doesn't mean anything, so we can actually close this out. And again, we got the dialog boxes going on here. Oh crap. And let's get out of this. So again, I'm actually going to launch that one last time for you, because I completely forgot I had Chrome minimized at the bottom there, and I know you're probably sitting there like, haha, it didn't work. It does. Just, I was a little careless there, so let's launch that one more time. And why is Chrome not, oh, wait a minute, it's because of my batch file. I'm an idiot. Alright. CMD, shutdown, /8 abort, abortion is done. Not abortion. Alright. So actually, I forgot, in my batch file, I forgot to update it. Let's edit this one. I forgot to take this minimize out. So, there we go. Now it should work correctly. And if you minimize again, I quit. There we go. Bam. Third time's a charm. Yes, I know you're going to shut down, but you are not going to shut down. CMD. Alright. So that is what the successful version looks like. So we got the command prompt going, doing its thing. To the average person that's not tech savvy the least bit, this looks like hell. I'm sitting here losing my mind thinking, oh shit, I'm losing everything on my computer. That's really not the case. Let's get out of all this crap. And close that out. So this, I actually think, would be pretty effective on college campuses, because you know how, if you're a college viewer right now, I'm sure you can relate to this. I know a lot of college students out there spend a good amount of their semester writing that one big paper that you have to submit at the end of the year and basically determines if you pass or fail. Well, imagine hitting a friend or family member with this prank. That is going to really put a sweat on their back, because if you notice on the last part of this VBS file, it tells you, please have your recovery disk ready to reinstall Windows, which basically tells you, you're going to lose everything in about less than a minute. Now, we both know that this is not the case at all, but it's really going to give you that whole oh crap factor. And that's really what I wanted to achieve with this video. Again, I hope this was fun and educational for you, and just kind of really opens you up to not just doing one thing at once, but kind of like doing a lot of things at the same time, really giving it a more unique aspect. Any comments or suggestions are greatly appreciated. And again, I will be posting the batch file in the in the description below, and I will give you the tools on how to set up the VBS file as well. All right, thank you.